Thank you very much for the opportunity, and thank you to Senator Simmons being on, which is expressed interest in the legislation. As a number of my colleagues here who are co-sponsors from the Democratic Conference, the issue about public hearing, just to clarify, by moving the bill's rules, yes, the Senate Conference, the Democratic Conference, can have a forum on that, but we can't have a proper public hearing, which I think is, you know, obviously a very different animal than a public forum being conducted by the minority workers. That said, we will take care of that option, of course. But I do think that we have heard time and time again from advocates and legal experts that the statute of limitations for chronic child sexual abuse is broken in New York. It's incredibly restrictive in New York. We are one of the most restrictive states in the nation. If you do not file a claim by the age of 23, essentially, you do not have the right for civil or criminal redress in court. And that's why, simply, we need to fix it. That's why there's such widespread support for it. That's why the governor put it in his state of the state. We are eager to work with all parties to get a bill that works, to make certain that young people have the opportunity to file a claim. This chamber does a very good job of pointing out that we need to protect our kids, and we need to make certain that sexual predators do not go free in the state, and we need to pass numerous bills in connection with that. Here is a glaring loophole in our statutes, where today there are thousands, as is estimated, of predators who have abused children, still with access to kids, whether they be in private or public school settings. The bill that I drafted with the cooperation of our colleagues for the first time addresses both the public and the private components, and would set a reasonable period for current claims to be revived for civil matters. That has occurred in a number of states without the concern of fraud or caseloads being running rampant. So I do think that there is precedent in other states for fixing the statute of limitations. We have seen, for example, in California, in Delaware, and Connecticut, where they've done so, have achieved justice for people who have been abused as children, and at the same time move forward with a justice system that respects the rights of both